and concerns have been raised over the dire state of the Dick Montshioa Airport. This is in Mahikeng in the northwest. The Northwest Portfolio Committee on Public Works making an announcement that they are going to conduct an oversight visit to the airport. They say the dire state of that airport is disappointing, and that's where we find our reporter Refiloe Seboko, who joins us now. Refiloe, good morning to you. Just how bad is the state of this airport if the members of the portfolio committee have seen it necessary to actually pay it a visit?
Extremely bad, Tloli, I think if one can say it. This is what used to be the state of the art Dick Montshioa Airport here in Mahikeng, but the state that we are seeing right now, it's really dire. It's not how it should be. It's not how it used to be, and this is why concerns are being raised, particularly by the Portfolio Committee and members of the Northwest Legislature. Ntate Tshwaile, thank you so much and welcome to Newsroom Africa. Let's talk about this oversight visit and, you know, what you have seen, what your concerns are so far.
Of course, there are multiplicity of concerns. As the Portfolio Committee, we have made efforts to redress on these concerns. Amongst them, they include that the international operation license for this airport was allocated to Pilanesberg Airport, which is smaller, just for the convenience of tourism. But worse, we have private jets or planes that are landing and departing here, where we do not even have SARS on site, we do not have Home Affairs, and they are posing serious national security threat. At one point, when we made a visitation here, there was kind of a cargo package that was kept here that we couldn't explain why it was here and what was it. Other than that, there is a poor maintenance of the infrastructure that we have here, despite multiple millions being allocated for the purpose of maintenance of this infrastructure. But you can realize that given how it is a serious risk. We can have fire here. We do not even have fire people on the site. We do not have all necessary equipment that would help in case of fire. Other than that, of course, the security here should be the specialized security, given that this is a serious national key point. But we have a security that is not necessarily armed, even if it has been contracted as a specialized security. And we can assure you that the highly flammable liquids that we have suggest that we are not far from experiencing a really bad risk.
When you raised the issue of security officials as you were doing a walkabout together, you're also noting that a total number of security officials that are supposed to be on the ground, they are not here. Issues of their payment as well, you have raised as one of your concerns.
Yes, of course. We have said there is something that is wrong that is being done by the department, that is taking the security personnel allocated for the airport to their offices in town, when the same security here that is operating here is not contracted to work at the offices in the town. Secondly, the total number of the security officials that we expect on the site is not complete, despite that the service provider would claim for the number that is contracted. But you would realize that on our last visit on the 31st of March, we had even a scenario where we had a security company not having batteries for their torch. So if they are not armed and they do not have a simple torch to do the perimeter security risk assessment, then you can just realize. But also the security personnel themselves are at risk because of this bush, the snakes, and the possibility of them being attacked at the site. We cannot tell how much of the petrol or fuel on the site is being stolen, and many other things that are critical asset. We can't give you guarantees of what is happening here.
Let me move out of short. Thank you so much, Ntate Tshwaile. Let me move out of short, Tloli, just so that my colleague boys can show you some of the state when Mr. Tshwaile talks about the bushes and some of their concerns. I'm also, you know, joined by Lebohang Kaba from the EFF. EFF in the Northwest. And Dr. Klaba, your concerns as well as the opposition party in the province.
Yeah, thank you very much and good afternoon to everyone. Like my colleagues are saying, that really this place is so dilapidated that you will never even think that this is a government, expensive government building. Nothing is happening here, and I'm just worried because since 2019 I joined legislature here. We sit in the portfolio committee where the department will always look for money to come. Every year they buy it for this place, Dick Montshioa and that business back, but nothing is happening really. You just ask us, where are those millions going? Really, I don't see any differences, I don't see any change. The only change that I've seen here is the name change, Dick Montshioa Airport, but nothing else. Really, like my colleagues were saying, that if we have inflammable stuff like this one, and then there's not even a single fire extinguisher around this thing, then what if maybe the place caught flames and there's a lot of grass all over here, so many bushes. Really, it's, even the security, you cannot even see it. When you they say there's two security posts at the other side, you have to go and search for them. You can't even see them. They're just in the bushes. This is a very dangerous place. It's not like it's a government place. Mm-hmm. Really, it's too bad.
And what is it in the club that you would want to be done?
Really, it's not a matter of saying I want. There's money that we pump every year. What is that money doing? Is it only paying the service providers like the security? You even ask us, what is the security doing here? Because there's nothing for them to guard here. They are not guarding anything. There's money that we pump. Even they say they got the money. Last year they got the money. And they will tell you they are doing the perimeter fence, or they will tell you, just look at this run here. Really, they've been telling us that they are preparing and fixing the run, but it's still the same. And I don't see any changes here. Mm-hmm. It's still better. Just process the respect expenditure.
Thank you so much for your time. Lebohang Klaba from the EFF in the Northwest. I'm going to ask my colleague Boyce to just show you the run that Mr. Klaba was talking about. It's the Dick Montshioa Airport, clearly together with our viewers, what used to be the state-of-the-art airport, something that you remember also previously. I remember MEC of Kokta in the Northwest, Nono Maloyi, during the Lekgotla, had made mention of how this facility, together with the Pilanisberg Airport that needs to be revamped, but also Ndati Chwaile, together with Mr. Klaba, raising an issue of money that is being budgeted to fix, maintain these airports, but that does not seem to be the problem. The issue of maintenance, the issue of the dire state of the airport as a whole, the issue of security officials not having necessary resources for them to be able to work. That's why they are raising it and saying that something needs to be done so that this airport can go back to its normal state.
Yeah, Refiloe Seboko, thank you very much. Live for us there at the Dick Montshioa Airport. That's in the northwest at the capital there. Why would the airport be allowed to go into a state such as the one it is in right now? It's an open-ended question.